Hey, what's going on, peeps? I'm Rex, and I'm here to talk to you guys a little bit, without any games. I mean, you can see something in there, in the background, but I'm not actually playing it right now, if you understand the concepts of time, and how I'm manipulating time through the power of editing, or whatever. I'm here because I just want to say thank you, everyone, for being so awesome, for watching the videos and commenting and liking. You guys are the best, and I honestly just wanted to take like 20 seconds to say that because I do believe that you guys are great. And there are actually a lot of things that I want to talk about for all of the series that I'm making, including some of the ones that are going to be happening in the future. For now, Dark Souls. So Dark Souls, so we've been doing it for a while and it's been quite great. It's such a fun game. It's really kind of tough, but obviously that's kind of expected. I wanted to talk about what I have in stock for the game in the future, since I know that some of you guys have been wondering what am I going to do, how, if I'm ever going to be doing challenges for the game, and the answer is yes. I'm planning on doing a hardcore challenge for Dark Souls. If you don't know, there's actually an achievement that I believe even comes with a weapon or something. If you manage to finish the game without dying once with one character, if you don't die at all for the entire playthrough and you kill the last boss, I believe you get an achievement and you get a weapon for that. It's something in the game that does that, and I think that's a worthy challenge for us to partake. Obviously, I'm gonna do that as soon as I finish the actual let's play of it, the blind softcore let's play, and then I'm gonna do that. I'm also thinking of doing a soul level 1 challenge, which will require me to not level the character at all, to start with the unclothed Enigma and just leave it at level 1 and then just kind of see how I can do it. Go through the game just with that character being level 1. It can be done. I know that in Dark Souls 1 it used to be a lot easier, since you could actually spend your souls to power your Pyromancy Flame. In this game you cannot, since you use fire seeds in order to upgrade your Pyromancy Flame. You can't just drop in all of your overflowing souls to that, so it's gonna be a little bit more complicated, but yeah, it's a challenge, right? It's gonna be amazing just to try and make that happen. Those are the two things that I want to do, at least for the foreseeable future, for Dark Souls. I do want to spend a lot of my time, resources on Dark Souls, because I think it's just such an awesome, awesome game, and it seems like you guys are really enjoying it, so I'm really happy about that. Also, I've been receiving questions, this one by VGP901. you guys are concerned about me skipping dialogues, and I guess I want to address that. I will be doing lore videos eventually. I'm not sure how long it's gonna take before I can do that. It might be a little while. I do obviously want to finish the game first before I start to dissect the game, to break it down. I do want to finish the game so that I'm not spoiled anything. And I feel, I don't know, I just don't want, because I know that you have to talk to a lot of characters in Dark Souls. It's something that I don't particularly enjoy as much. It's something that I wish it would be more similar to Dark Souls 1, where some of the quests were more about you talking to the person once, and that would be it. But instead here, you have to go through like 4 paragraphs of dialogue, and you need to continuously just talk to these people in order to progress your quest. I don't like that, more specifically because, well, it does take a lot of time, but like, I just imagine just going through a second or third or fourth playthrough and just talking to these people over and over again when I already know their whole dialogue. It's just, it seems to me like it's just a waste of time. I don't know if I appreciate that. I don't like it. And in a lot of ways, it feels like it just takes too long on a video. Like, a conversation, if I just let it happen, it could take 3 or 4 minutes out of a 20-minute video, and I don't know, I guess I want to know what you guys think about it, if I should just actually let them talk, or if you're fine with me just covering it on a lore video. I figure that I can just go through the game, enjoy it, and then later just kind of go through the lore. I thought that would be the best way to go about doing things, but I would enjoy your comments on this, so let me know. And that's Dark Souls 2. So Spider-Man has been amazing. I enjoy Spider-Man. It's funny because there are so many haters out there, and by haters I mean everyone. the reviews on the game are abysmal, man. They all give the game crap. IGN gave it like a 4.5 or something. The Metacritic is at like 54 out of 100. Like, it's doing horrible, horrible, horrible on the reviews. And people as well, including Ashley and literally everyone I've talked to, dismiss the game because it's, I don't know, the combat is not good enough for them. The physics are not good enough for them. The story is not good enough for them. And it's funny because I've been having the most amazing time with the game. I cannot stop laughing and smiling when I'm playing the game. I think this is why I just cannot be a reviewer. It doesn't matter how hard I try. I can't look at a game just objectively and just like dissect it in a critic way of doing it. Like, I can't. I think it's funny because when I watch movies, like, I don't see the movie and just go like, oh, I like how the lightning did whatever, they did this in the scenario, I like how they make me feel. Like, I can't, it's very hard for me to look at something in that objective kind of a, outside of the third barrier, you know, like looking at it through a critic. I just enjoy it for what it is. And Spider-Man, since it's such a topic that it's bound by, you know, like, we all grew up with Spider-Man, at least some of us, I'm guessing. It's something that just makes me happy. It's Spider-Man, it's such a lovely character. I love the movies, I love the comics, I love just the old video games, the Spider-Man, I guess more specifically Spider-Man 2 that everyone loved. It makes me happy. It really just makes me happy to be able to play Spider-Man. And it's funny, I'll never be a reviewer because of that, because I'm just so biased towards being positive rather than being negative. And, well, I guess it is what it is, right? But I just find that really interesting, and I really hope you guys are enjoying the series as well, because it's so fun for me to just enjoy that. It's such a childhood, like, hero of mine, so it's fun, it's been fun. And lastly, Don't Starve. So Don't Starve, so Paladin Newell mentioned something that I thought it was really cool and maybe even crucial to this type of challenges. Because for the longest time, I've been of the idea that I would record a challenge in its entirety and then I would upload it if I succeeded, right? Because I figured that it would make me look kind of silly or dumb, or people would make fun of me if I would, like, go, you know, through all the lengths to, like, make this awesome challenge and then just, like, lose. And I don't know, for some reason, I guess I just felt embarrassed that that would happen, that I would just lose a challenge and people would make fun of me or something. So I figured that I would just, like, do that. I would just finish the entire challenge and then upload it so that I know that I would, you know, that I would succeed and that people would enjoy watching it, that it just wouldn't be like a bust or something. But he mentioned something that I think is very interesting, that maybe it's better if we don't know if I'm gonna succeed, because if that happens, then every video becomes a struggle. You don't know if I'm gonna die on the next video of Don't Starve. You don't know if I'm gonna die two or three episodes after this one, and it makes it more exciting. It makes every episode feel like, yeah, I mean, I guess like a struggle. Like anything can happen. I'm leading you into disappointment, maybe. The recording of this video, like, I haven't actually died yet, and I think I'm doing really, really well, and it's hard. Sometimes it is hard. I think it's been, like, two times where I've been, like, literally one hit from dying, and that could have just ended the entire challenge, which would have been extremely disappointing, but it didn't, and I'm continuing it, and it's, maybe it is more exciting that way, and I want you guys to tell me what you guys think about that, because it's also very interesting, and I want to know if you guys would rather me just, like, if you guys would be okay with me just, like, failing a challenge and just living it right there, or making a hardcore series where I actually legitimately die in the middle of it and just living it there, and, like, as an end, just, I just died and that's it, and then just moving along. I would be something that I would really enjoy if you guys would give me some comments on that. But now, what's in the future for as far as other games are concerned? Because Spider-Man, I believe we're going to be ending it maybe in about, I would say 10 more episodes maybe, and it's going to end so in about 10 days or so. Dark Souls is going to take longer, but Don't Starve could end at any point in time. So what other games am I going to be playing? So, Bound by Flame, it's a game that I've been, I literally just saw it. It's what's in Steam, and apparently, like, I guess Steam is, like, promoting it, and it comes out in, like, 2 days, or by the time you're looking at this tomorrow, it's coming out tomorrow, the 8th of May. The game looks amazing! The graphics are, like, awesome, the animations, the cinematics, they all look amazing. It reminds me of Dragon Age. If it had the combat of Kingdoms of Amalur, which is an amazing sexual combination that inspires so much love from every part of my body right now. That's what I like, man. I just want a nice, awesome RPG that has a lot of focus on story that just captivates me, and that it has some kind of leveling system. I just want another Dragon Age, man. I just want a Dragon Age with another IP, right? That's what I want. I want Dragon Age 3, man. I can't wait for that. But this seems to be pretty close to that, and I am so excited because it's coming out tomorrow, and I just had no idea. And suddenly, the fact that tomorrow I'm gonna have a really cool game, it makes me crazy. So I'm gonna be doing this. I don't know how long it's gonna be. I honestly have no idea. I just hope it's not that long, so that we can continue to make, to play other games and stuff. I don't want to make just I'm gonna be stuck with like 3 or 4 Let's Plays at the same time, and that's gonna destroy me, man. I don't think I can handle that. But that's something that I've been keeping an eye on, and I hope you guys enjoy. Next is Transistor. Now, this one was something that I've actually been keeping an eye on for a while now. And why? Well, it's from the developers of Bastion. For those of you who have been following me for a while, Bastion is one of my, literally, I think it's my, one of my top 5 games of all time. It's such a good game. I did a Let's Play on it on Rex Plays. If you guys want to see it, the link is in the description if you want to go and see that. But the game shares the same art style, shares the same concept and graphic style, and I don't know if it has the narration style. I think that's very Bastion-y, so I honestly wouldn't know if it has that. I haven't seen that many trailers of it. I'm keeping myself blind for that, but I trust the guys. I honestly, after Bastion, I am like open and ready for business. But these guys, I'm literally in bed, just like, draw me like one of your French girls, just do whatever you want with me. I'm ready. My buddy's ready for your game, bros. And I can't wait. It's I've been hearing so much about it too, because I listen to a lot of podcasts. And man, they've been talking about this. They've been hyping this game up for a while now, and I cannot wait. So, it comes out on the 20th, so there's still a while longer before this happens, but it's still in this month, so I am looking forward to it. And the last one is Watch Dogs. Everyone knows Watch Dogs. It's coming out on the 27th. I'm gonna be covering it as well. Hopefully a full Let's Play of it. It's probably the one that I'm the most excited about out of all of this. Even though I hype them up a lot, this is even more. Why? Well, shit, dude. It's Watch Dogs. We've been waiting for this for a very long time. This game has been hyping for the past, like, a couple of years, dude. Like, right? Everyone has been waiting for Watch Dogs. The trailer, as you can see, it just looks amazing. The concept is awesome. The hacking system, it's like seems like a Grand Theft Auto combined with like an Assassin's Creed or something. Like, you're just going around the city, hacking things and escaping from crime and doing. There's apparently this crazy, crazy conspiracy theory story on the game, which is why I'm linking it to, I guess, Assassin's Creed, but more of similar to what Grand Theft Auto is, I guess. Man, oh man. That's gonna be a blast, and I cannot wait for that one either. So that's the future, guys, for the channel. That's just my take on everything that I'm doing right now and everything that I'm gonna be doing for the foreseeable future. Let me know if you guys have any questions on all of this, if you guys agree, if you guys disagree, if you guys think there's a game that you guys will think I should play, or if any of these games you think I shouldn't play for whatever reason. Just if you guys have anything to say, just say it, man. I'm open, okay? Open and ready for business. I'm ready to take your criticisms. But yeah, I hope you all continue to watch my videos, and I'll see you guys next time.